welcome in our English online class. Students, in our previous class, we have already started a new chapter of English grammar, that is chapter number 13, prepositions. We have learned that prepositions are the words which tells us the relationship between a noun or a pronoun, or you can say another noun or a pronoun. Prepositions also tells the position of a noun or a pronoun. As if you look at the word preposition, and if you will break the word into parts, the word will become pre plus position. So it means the preposition word tells the position of a noun or a pronoun. Suppose I put my marker in the box. So where is the marker at now? In the box. So the word in tells us the position of the marker. Okay, and it tells us the relationship between the marker and the box. Okay, so we have learned the preposition of place, under which we have learned the usage of at, it, and on. And we have also learned the preposition of time, under which we have learned the usage of in, at, and on. So today we will do the book exercises of this chapter. So let's begin today's lesson with the first exercise, that is exercise number A. Identify where at is used as a preposition of place and where it is used as a preposition of time. Okay, now the sentences have been given to you. You have to identify that at which place the preposition has been used as a preposition of place and at which place it has been used as a preposition of time. So the first sentence is, the train is likely to arrive at 5 o'clock. Now we have to identify at preposition. So where is the preposition in the sentence? It's here, at. Now after this at, what has it here, students? 5 o'clock. That denotes the time. So at 5 o'clock, it means in this sentence we are talking about the preposition of time. Okay, so here for time we have to write only T, and for place we will write P. Okay, capital, not small. So here we will write T, that denotes that in the sentence the at preposition has been used as preposition of time. Now next sentence we have, always read the notes in the box at the bottom of the page. Now here again we have to search that where is my preposition in this sentence. So at is a preposition in the sentence. Now after at, what are the words in the sentence? The bottom of the page. It means in the sentence we are not talking about the time, but here we are talking about the place. At the bottom of the page, that denotes the place of the page. Bottom or top? So here it means in this sentence we will use the preposition at as a preposition of place, not time. Okay, so what we will write here? Capital P, don't write small p. Okay, so in the blank we will write capital P, that denotes preposition of place. Okay students, the rest of the sentences of this exercise also you will do in the same manner in your grammar book. Now let's move toward the next exercise, that is exercise number B. Write P for place and T for time. Now here in this sentence we will search the in preposition in the sentence, and then we have to identify the in preposition has been used, whether it has been used as the preposition of place or preposition of time. Okay, and again you will write P for place and T for time. Okay, but both the letters should be capital. Now the first sentence I have, my grandmother was born in 1950. Now first of all we will search the preposition in the sentence. Okay, now in we have to search, so where is in the sentence? It's here, before the year. Okay, and with years means year, when we use place or time? When we talk about the time, that time we we will write here P, capital T. Okay, that denotes preposition of time. Now next sentence we have, we grow vegetables in the garden. Now again we will search the preposition in the sentence. So here it's here in. Now after in the words the garden. The garden, that tells us the place, a particular place we are talking about in the sentence. So it means the preposition has been used as a preposition of place. So we will write here P, that is capital P, that denotes preposition of place. Okay students, now rest of sentence the same manner we will do in your grammar book. Now next exercise, that is exercise number C, and in this exercise we will use on preposition. Okay, and again we are using here both the preposition as place and as time. So for place you will write capital P and for time you will write capital T. Okay, capital P and capital T. Now first sentence we have, place the carpet on the floor. Now first thing, whenever you will read a sentence, the first thing you have to do is to search the preposition in the sentence. So the preposition in the sentence is on. Okay, we have learned the at, it, on. So on is the preposition in the sentence. Now after on, what are the words in the sentence? On the floor. So the floor, and the floor tells that we are talking about the place. Okay, so again we will write here P. Okay, that is preposition of place. So in this sentence, on has been used as a preposition of place. Now next sentence we have, let us have a party on Friday. Now first of all, search the preposition in the sentence. Where is it? It's here, on. Now after on, there is a day, Friday, and to refer dates and days, we use on preposition as a preposition of time. So here what will come in the blank? Capital T, that denotes preposition of time. Okay students, so in the same manner you will do the other sentences of this exercise in your grammar book. Now next is exercise number E. Now rewrite these sentences using the correct prepositions. Now in the sentence what you have to do, the sentences have been written in the terms. Now what you have to do here, the prepositions has been written wrong. Okay, wrong prepositions have been written, so we have to identify the correct preposition and then we have to write the sentence again. Okay, so the first sentence is, my birthday is in 16 November. Now okay, now here what is the preposition? In. Now students, with dates, okay, in the last exercise only we have done this, that with days and with days we use on preposition. Okay, so here this is the wrong preposition, and in place of this preposition with date we will use on. So the correct sentence is, my birthday is on. Okay, here on will come. Okay students, because with dates and with days, when we talk about dates and days, we use on preposition. Okay, my birthday is on 22nd January. Her birthday is on. So on will come when we talk about the dates and days. Now next sentence we have, the show commence means begin or start on 3 o'clock. So here the preposition is on. Now students, with time period, when we talk about the time period, that time we use most of the time at preposition. I will come to meet you at 5 o'clock. I will go to play at 5 o'clock in the evening. So with time, most of the time, the time clock, when we talk about a clock of time clock, that time we use at preposition. Okay, so it means this is wrong. Now we have to rectify it, and again we have to rewrite the sentence with the correct preposition. So the new sentence will be, the show It is very cold on winter. Now here, this is wrong. On. When we talk about the seasons, which seasons we use in prepositions, not on, not at. Okay. In spring season, we celebrate Holi festival in spring season. Okay. We use umbrella in rainy season. So when we talk about the seasons, we use in preposition, not on, and we not use at preposition. So that is the wrong one. Now we will write the sentence again with the correct preposition. So the new sentence is, it is very cold in winter. Okay students, now next sentence we have, I was in the train on 6 o'clock. Okay, so the preposition of sentence is on. Okay, now as we have done in a sentence, that with time, sentence number 2, sorry, that is sentence number 2, we have done now the show commences on 3 o'clock. So that time also we talked that with time, with the exact clock time, we use at preposition. So again here, with the clock time, we will use at preposition. So the new correct sentence is, I was in the train at 6 o'clock. Okay students, so in this manner the rest of the sentences you will do yourself as a homework in your grammar books. So